As every gardener knows, it's no bed of roses trying to keep the pests from the blooms. But Hertfordshire scientists have come up with an environmentally friendly way of getting rid of male aphids that takes advantage of their lust. And if tests are successful, it should help gardeners everywhere. This microscope is magnifying an aphid's two antennae. The antennae detect the smell of nearby lady aphids. The scientist's needle is putting a special chemical onto a crucial part of the antennae, and the aphid is fooled into thinking he's about to meet a girlfriend. This is the painstaking technique that enabled the Rothamsted scientists to be the first in the world to detect the exact chemical which lady aphids put out to attract their menfolk. It was detected by putting thousands of aphid scents onto the male antenna until one produced a... The aphid's lust may be their downfall. The chemical can be made from catmint. Experimental traps with it have caught thousands of excited aphids.
Well, it's really very exciting because we can now catch a great deal of the male aphids at this very vulnerable stage when they move from the summer host to their winter breeding site.
What gave you the idea that this might be a technique that would work?
Well, we knew from Swedish colleagues that there was, in fact, a sex pheromone or sex attractant that attracts the males to the females, but no other groups could identify this material, and we've succeeded to do that very recently.
The chemical the female uses to attract the male varies for different kinds of aphids, but all have been detected at Rothamsted. Traps scented with the chemicals could be a boon to horticulturalists uneasy about using pesticides. How big a problem are aphids, green fly?
Well, earlier in the season they were a great problem and we got rid of them. We control them by spraying with pesticides.
Would you prefer a different method?
Well, of course, if you can get rid of them without killing the other insects as well, that's fine. Yes, yes, I'm looking forward to trying it.
Simon Neave in Hertfordshire for Thames News.